Good evening, everyone, and welcome to St. Andrew the Apostle Catholic Church meeting. In a few minutes from now, we're going to be witnessing the solemn celebration of the consecration of the meeting. This celebration will be broadcast around the world via live stream. So I want to also take this moment to acknowledge and welcome all our friends and brothers and sisters who are watching and celebrating with us via the internet. To our fellow missionary brothers and sisters, and all those from abroad, hola, amigos en Cristo, buenas noches, bienvenido. Hello, friends in Christ, good evening and welcome. My name is Mike Janice, and I stand before you tonight with the distinct pleasure of not only representing the mission for the love of God worldwide, but also as a lifelong resident of Gaeta. It's also a great honor and a privilege as well to be alongside my fellow parishioners, as I too have been a lifelong parishioner of St. Peter's. Tonight we're going to be witnessing a historic event, not only for the town of Gaeta, but for the Diocese of Lafayette and for the state of Louisiana. Our town will be the first municipality in Louisiana to be consecrated to God Almighty through the Sacred Heart of Jesus and the Immaculate Heart of Mary. We will witness the joining of church and state as Christians and citizens. The goal of the mission for the love of God worldwide is to restore the consciousness of God the Father as the center of our daily lives and fulfillment of the first commandment, and also in fulfillment of our Lord's request to love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, and with all your soul, and therefore love your neighbor as yourself. This goal is accomplished with the four cornerstones, and if you think about it for a second, that's exactly what's going to be occurring. First, as a cornerstone of consecration, not only will the town of Gaeta be consecrated this evening, but we will all be consecrating ourselves and our families as well. I encourage all here this evening to join in a recitation of this prayer. Second cornerstone is metanoia. Metanoia is a Greek transliteration meaning a transformative change of heart, especially a spiritual conversion. In simple words, it means to be a better person by changing your demeanor. Being a better person makes us better brothers and sisters, sons and daughters, and not to forget, it makes us better parents. Tonight, this extends to the goal of becoming better citizens. The third cornerstone is prayer from the heart. My brothers and sisters, let us open our hearts tonight to the Lord, our God. Let us open our hearts to join the Sacred Heart of Jesus and the Immaculate Heart of Mary. If we open our hearts, our minds will then be open to better understand and accept the scripture and what our Holy Father wants from us. Let us have the faith to truly believe in him and embrace his love for us to help us become better persons. And finally, the fourth cornerstone is good works. This cornerstone ties the first three together. Once we're consecrated, once we have a change of heart, once we've opened our hearts and minds to be better people, good works will naturally occur through the community. Let us be the light that helps others see. Let us have the strength to be able to profess our Christian faith and not to allow ourselves to be the children of God who have gone silent. Let us stand up for our traditions, morals, values, and ethics, which we once had and grew up with. Let us all become better people together. Bit of house cleaning. As a reminder, in order to receive Holy Communion, we need to be a Catholic in the state of grace, not conscious of any mortal sin. Catholics who cannot at this time receive the Holy Eucharist, and non-Catholics who are invited to remain in your pupil communion and pray for a spiritual communion, or cross your arms in order to receive a blessing from the priest. I encourage all to come up and at least receive a blessing. Thank you. May God bless all of us. May Our Lady of Guadalupe continue to watch over us. Amen. I now ask all of you to please rise and remain standing for a few moments. I invite Zachary and Johnny Brooke, two Eagle Scouts, to please enter and present the colors. I pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Prayers and readings for tonight's celebration can be found on page 8 of your programs. Our opening hymn is How Great Thou Art. Please join the choir with the singing of the entrance hymn as we greet our celebrant, Bishop Douglas Desitel.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
I just wanted to, in the name of the parish, welcome everyone. This night has been a long time in the coming, and welcome in a special way our bishop and also representative and ministers from the area churches and our local government. Welcome.
My brothers and sisters, as we prepare to celebrate the sacred mystery, let us call to mind those times in our lives that we have not lived up to our calling as children of God and followers of the Lord Jesus, and ask the good Lord for his healing and forgiveness in our lives. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Clothe us, Lord God, with the virtues of the heart of your Son, and set us aflame with his love, that, conformed to his image, we may merit to share in eternal redemption. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "And now, Israel, what does the Lord your God ask of you? But to fear the Lord your God and follow his ways exactly, to love and serve the Lord your God with all your heart and all your soul, to keep the commandments and statutes of the Lord, which I enjoin on you today for your own good. Think, the heavens, even the highest heavens, belong to the Lord your God, as well as the earth and everything on it. Yet in his love for your fathers, the Lord was so attached to them as to choose you, their descendants, in preference to all other people, as indeed he has now done. Circumcise your hearts, therefore, and be no longer stiff-necked. For the Lord your God is the God of gods, the Lord of lords, the great God, mighty and awesome, who has no favorites, accepts no bribes, who executes justice for the orphan and the widow, and befriends the alien, feeding and clothing them. So you too must befriend the alien, for you were once aliens yourselves in the land of Egypt. The Lord your God shall you fear, and him shall you serve. Hold fast to him and swear by his name. He is your glory, he your God, who has done for you those great and terrible things which your own eyes have seen. Your ancestors went down to Egypt 70 strong, and now the Lord your God has made you as numerous as the stars of the sky." The word of the Lord.
The Lord's kindness is everlasting to those who fear him.
The Lord's kindness is everlasting to those who fear him.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all my blessed being. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits.
The Lord's kindness is everlasting to those who fear him.
He pardons all your iniquities. He heals all your ills. He redeems your life from destruction. He crowns you with kindness and compassion. The Lord's kindness is everlasting to those who fear him. The Lord secures justice and the rights of all of the oppressed. He has made known his ways to Moses and his deeds to the children of Israel. The Lord's kindness is everlasting to those who fear him. Merciful and gracious is the Lord, slow to anger and abounding in kindness. Not according to our sins does he deal with us, nor does he requite us according to our crimes. The Lord's kindness is everlasting. A reading from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, I kneel before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named, that he may grant you, in accord with his riches, of his glory, to be strengthened with power through his Spirit in the inner self, and that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, that you, rooted and grounded in love, may have the strength to comprehend with all the holy ones what is the breadth and length and height and depth, and to know the love of Christ that surpasses knowledge, so that you may be filled with the fulfillments of God. The word of the Lord. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you, and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment. Love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friend. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends, because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you, and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. This I command you, love one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
It's a great honor and a great joy for me to be with all of you here this evening for this special occasion in the city of Gaydon. I join your pastor, Father Campo, and also Father David Rosa from Church Point, who are celebrating the Mass this evening, in welcoming all of you. I welcome especially you, Mayor. Thanks for being here this evening. You do us a great honor. Welcome also all of the police officers and sheriff's deputies, and also the first responders who are present here this evening. Thank you for your service to this community. And also to welcome my brother Knights, the Color Corps from the Knights of Columbus, who are here this evening to give great beauty in our ceremony this evening. We heard in the gospel reading, of our Lord's words, there is no greater love than to lay down one's life for one's friends. Our reflection and meditation on the Sacred Heart of Jesus is a reflection on the great love that the Lord Jesus displayed for each and every one of us. The human heart is the seat of love. We tell someone whom we fall in love with, "You stole my heart." We still give hearts on Valentine's Day as a sign of our love for others. And the Lord instructs us in the gospel to imitate God's love for us by our love for each other. It was a young man who was born in Ville Platte, Louisiana, by the name of Verbus Lafleur. Verbus Lafleur was born in Ville Platte, grew up in the city of Opelousas, and at a young age he felt a calling to be a priest, so he entered the seminary and was ordained a priest for the Diocese of Lafayette. His first parish as a young priest was to serve at St. Mary Magdalene in Abbeville, Louisiana. And it was there when the Second World War broke out, and he felt a calling to serve the servicemen in the army as a chaplain. So he joined the army and ended up in the Philippines at the very beginning of the Second World War. When the Philippines fell, he and a number of soldiers were taken prisoner by the Japanese and put in POW camps. They were very harshly treated. They had very little food, no medicine, suffered great diseases. And the other prisoners noticed how Father Lafleur made great sacrifices for them, seeing to their spiritual needs, but also trading some of his personal items with the Japanese to obtain extra food that he could bring to the sickest of the prisoners. He dedicated his service to relieving their suffering and taking care of their spiritual needs. As the war began to wind down, the Japanese had a program of bringing all of the prisoners of war to the homeland of Japan. And so they put them on the POW ships. And then while it was on transit to Japan, the ship was struck by a torpedo and began to sink. All of the prisoners were in the bow of the ship, along with Father Lafleur. And he spent his time that was left on the ship helping the injured and the wounded POWs up through the hatch in the deck to try and escape and swim away from certain death. And he let them take his place in getting out of the ship before it sank. He gave his life that others might live. I'm sure he had reflected on these words of our Lord in the gospel that we just heard read. There is no greater love than to lay down one's life for one's friends. Jesus exhorts us in the gospel to imitate the love that he has for us by loving our neighbor. At the end of St. Matthew's gospel, Jesus tells that parable of who it is who will enter into everlasting life. When he tells the parable of the great king who declares to all of those on his right, "Enter into the joy of your Lord, for I was hungry and you gave me to eat. I was thirsty and you gave me to drink, a stranger and you came to visit me, naked and you clothed me." And they said, "Lord, when did we see you a stranger or hungry or thirsty or without clothing?" And his words to them were, "As often as you did it for one of the least of my brethren, you did it for me." And hence we have the recipe for harmony, the recipe for peace in this command of love that Jesus gives to us. A couple of Sundays ago, we had the gospel at Mass of the lawyer who came to Jesus to ask of all the laws of the Old Testament, and there were some 615 laws, which is the greatest? Our Lord's response to him was that we love God with our whole heart, mind, and soul, and the second, that we love our neighbor as ourselves. Our world today needs very sorely this important message. We can't turn the television on or open a newspaper or read an article online without finding some announcement of random killings, of total disregard for the sanctity of human life. How much our world needs this beautiful message that our Lord gives to us in the gospel today. As we dedicate this city to the Sacred Heart of Jesus, the Immaculate Heart of Mary, we ask to remember the symbol of the heart, the symbol of love, and to follow the Lord's request that we love our neighbor as he has loved us. God bless you all, and again, thank you for inviting me to be with you all on this special occasion this evening. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Please stand. Let us renew our commitment to live as children of God and followers of the Lord Jesus by renewing our baptismal promise. As I ask all of you, do you renounce Satan and all his works and empty promises?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it. In Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Act of consecration of the town of Gedo. I, Douglas Desitel, as Bishop of the Diocese of Lafayette, consecrate the town of Gedo, all the parishes, schools, priests, religious individuals, and families within the diocese in the town of Gedo and surroundings, to Almighty God, through the intercession of the Sacred Heart of Jesus and the Immaculate Heart of Mary. I surrender to God Almighty all that we are and everything that we have for his constant love and protection towards this town. Through this act of consecration, we ask God Almighty forgiveness for all transgressions made against his name and his commandments. We ask him that through his mercy we may repair the offenses committed to satisfy his divine justice, and that we may be filled with hopeful hearts for the future of Gedo and surroundings. I, Douglas Desitel, Bishop of the Diocese of Lafayette, proclaim this November 20th as the day of the consecration of the town of Gedo to God Almighty, through the Sacred Heart of Jesus and the Immaculate Heart of Mary. And we ask God to protect this act of consecration and to grant us the grace of renewing it every year without turning away from him.
I, Chris Terrio, Mayor of the town of Gedo, with the authority given to me, do hereby make an act of consecration of myself, my family, and the town of Gedo to the love and the protection of Almighty God through the intercession of the Sacred Heart of Jesus and the Immaculate Heart of Mary. We put into his loving hands our government with all its employees and the citizens whom we are under our responsibility. We offer to Almighty God our thoughts and decisions so that we may use them always for the good of this town and to always be guided by the values of the gospel. We ask God through the intercession of the Sacred Heart of Jesus and the Immaculate Heart of Mary to hear and accept our act of consecration and to cover this town with his special protection. In making this consecration, we ask God for his forgiveness and his mercy for all of the Gedo's past transgressions and for any of our decisions that may have gone against his commandments, and we ask for his help in changing all that distances us from him. I, Chris P. Terrio, as mayor of the town of Gedo, declare this solemn oath before God and the great people of this town this 20th day of November in the year of the Lord 2018, and declare this day as the day of the consecration of the town of Gedo. Amen.
Thank you.
Merciful Lord, with love and confidence, we offer now to you our petitions, asking that you help and bless all those of us united here tonight, and upon each resident of the town of Gaydon and the surrounding community.
Please respond, Lord, to hear our prayer. We pray for Pope Francis, Bishop Douglas Desertel, and for all your holy church, especially those in the town of Gaydon and surrounding communities, that they may be enlightened and strengthened with your Holy Spirit through the intercession of the Sacred Heart of Jesus and the Immaculate Heart of Mary. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all world leaders, especially our local political leaders and all municipal employees, that guided by your divine wisdom, that they may always work for the well-being and progress of our cities. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the teachers and educators in our schools, that with their talents, wisdom, and dedication, they will make a great difference in the academic and social formation of their students. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the people dedicated to the care, health, and safety of our citizens, that God may bless all doctors, nurses, paramedics, first responders, and firefighters. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our police force that they will continue to protect us and ensure the security and order in our town and surrounding areas, and that God may keep them safe from danger and help them to fulfill their role. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all marriages and families, that their homes be filled with love, tolerance, forgiveness, and respect, and that through the intercession of the Holy Hearts, united in perfect love, they may know how to raise their children according to the teachings of the gospel. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Tonight I come on behalf of Miss Roxanne, who lost her mom yesterday. We pray for all the veterans, especially the men and women who are serving in our military today. Protect them and their families as they protect us. Guide them as they serve as a guiding light for justice, equality, and compassion in this world, and preserve their minds, bodies, and souls as they preserve our freedom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the sick, for the homeless, for the prisoners, for the dying, for the undocumented workers, and for all the people suffering in the town of Gaydon and surrounding communities, especially the ones most in need of your love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we humbly acknowledge that we depend upon you for every good thing. Hear all of our needs and petitions, those that have been expressed, and those that we hold in the silence of our hearts. Grant them to us, for we make them through your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. O God, Father of mercy, who because of the great love with which you loved us, with untold goodness gave us your only begotten Son, grant, we pray, that being perfectly united with him, we may offer you worthy homage. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
To the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for raised up high on the cross, he gave himself up for us with a wonderful love, and poured out blood and water from his pierced side, the wellspring of the Church's sacrament, so that won over to the open heart of the Savior, all might draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Have mercy on us all, we pray, and with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages. May the marriage be co-heirs to eternal life. May I praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom and the power and glory of your Son. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you all.
Amen.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen. May the blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Let us pray. Made partakers in your sacrament of charity, we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that we may be conformed to Christ on earth and merit to be co-heirs of his glory in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Now it's my turn to stand before you with great pride, someone I couldn't be more proud of, to introduce you, the woman behind the consecration, my wife, Charlene.
What a blessed evening. For those of you that do not know me, my name is Charlene Janice. And I'm the Louisiana State Director and also the coordinator of consecrations for the Gaydon Council for the Mission for the Love of God Worldwide. Tonight, there's only one word we need to ponder. Yes. Yes. The founder for the Mission for the Love of God Worldwide, John Rick Miller, spoke many times about each one of us being called to become brave soldiers of Christ, fighting to save souls by becoming a flame in a time of darkness. We're in a world that is upside down, where right is wrong and wrong is right. Almost 2 years ago, I met with Mayor Theriault, and I asked him if he would consider consecrating the town of Gaydon. And his immediate response was yes. In June of this year, I was so blessed to have been able to visit with Bishop Desitel and to explain and introduce the mission to him. And before leaving, I asked him if he would consecrate the town of Gaydon. He too answered yes without hesitation. So I ask each one of you, are you willing to become a flame in a time of darkness by making the necessary changes in your lives, in your family, in this town and surrounding communities? Are you willing to say yes also? Through this consecration of Gaydon, we will be given an abundance of graces for each one of us to make the necessary changes needed in our lives. All we have to do is say yes. So on behalf of the Mission for the Love of God Worldwide, I thank you, Bishop Desitel and Mayor Theriault, for saying yes. I thank you, Mayor, for being courageous and for being a flame in this time of darkness. I thank your wife, Stella, for her supporting me in this endeavor. I also thank you, Father Campo, for allowing us to have this momentous and historic event. Thank you to all who have attended and all those who helped me organize this event. For my husband, Mike, who got very little sleep while working side by side with me, and for my friend and international director, Lillian Pierce, for guiding me through the very first consecration of a town in Louisiana to the Sacred and Immaculate Hearts of Mary. Hola to all of my brothers and sisters. So may God bless our town and the people in the surrounding communities. Thank you. And now I ask Bishop Desitel, Mayor Theriault, and Lillian Pierce, to come up for the signing of the proclamation.
I think Charlene was pretty thorough with all of her thanks, so I'll be brief, just to acknowledge everyone that helped in making this day possible. First, again, Charlene, you know, it's hard to imagine when you look from the outside just how much work goes into an event such like this, and Charlene did quite a bit of it, and Stephanie and Charles, the directors of the local council, and all the many people who helped them, our community choir, and everyone else. So I thank all of you from the bottom of my heart on behalf of the parish. And finally, I'd like to invite everyone to a light reception at the KC Hall. If you're visiting us from another parish, you take a left out of the parking lot here onto Main Street. It's about a block or two. It'll be on your right, across the street from the high school brick building. And last, I almost forgot, thank you to all of our sponsors who helped provide for the flowers and other things that are needed for the event that are listed in our program.
The Lord be with you. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Now, our help is in the name of the Lord. May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
The closing song is God Bless America. Please join him.